were halted in two key millers in Kisumu that resulted in thousands of losses. The farmers say they have to bear the loss as the trucks have stayed put for up to 5 days. The sugarcane farmers are accusing Kenya Union of Sugarcane Plantation and allied workers of a stalling leasing process by a court case. Kevin Ogutu traversed Nyando Sugar Belt and compiled the following report.
This weighbridge in Miwani, some truck drivers had stayed here with harvested cane for up to 5 days. This was Thursday of last week. Kibos Sugar Company had a major breakdown and could no longer take sugarcane for crushing. And one truck after another, a symbol of 18 months of farmers' patience, sweat and investment. And now farmers are in despair.
Sasa kama una pesa ya kutoa ile kitu inaitwa truth bill, yani kulipa kwanza ndio uende upeleke miwa yako inakoma kwa shamba. Sasa kwa ajili ya factory moja kiharibika vile kibosi iliharibika juzi, miwa imerundikana. Moroni imeshindwa kufanya nini? Kufanya kuchukua miwa yote. West Kenya pia wanachukua kwa muda. Sasa ukikata miwa yako bila mpango, umekuwa na shida kubwa sana.
At the same time, Horoni Sugar Company was undergoing a minor maintenance which further complicated the already dire situation.
Tumekaa na miwa kama siku tatu, siku ine hivi. Tumeomba tu serikali wanisaidie tengeneza hii masini ikuwe mzuri.
Sasa changamoto yenye tuko naye, breakdown ikitokea tunalala hapa siku tatu, siku ine, miwa zinaendelea zinaharibika. Ikishia kwa haitoi sukari vizuri, sasa payment inakaa. Mashini kiharibika miwa ikae inakuwa ngumu, sasa ndio inaongeza breakdown sana. Sasa tunaomba kama ya serikali inawezekana iturekebishie hizi machines, wakulima walipwe vizuri. Hata sisi tunategemea hapa, ngawaje tunaendesha matinga, tuko na jukumu zetu, tunasomesha watoto.
Kuna wakati unaweza toka unaenda shambani, unatuma uende shambani, labda unaenda mbali, labda mnaenda mnakwama huko, mnakaa kwa shamba hata muda kama siku mbili tatu, ndio mnakuja mnatolewa. Sasa mkishafika hapa kwenye line tena, unapata kuna shida tena. Unaona, mnakuja mnaketi hapa kwa line, mara unasikia sijui kuna breakdown fulani huko ndani, labda mashini imetokea na shida fulani, wanaambia nyinyi bado inarekebishwa mahali. Sasa hiyo tena ni changamoto tena kwa sisi madriver.
On the chopping board is Francis Wangara, the Secretary General of Kenya Union of Sugarcane Plantation and Allied Workers, who is among those who went to court to stop leasing of the 5 state-owned millers until what is owed to farmers is paid or a proper arrangement is put in place on how this will be done.
Kwa vile kuna mtu aliyepeleka kesi kwa koti, na sio mkulima, ni mfanyakazi wa factory. Vile alipeleka hizo vitu, kesa kila kitu imekwama.
We wrote a consent note to the minister and the office of the AG, because they are the ones representing the minister and Soro. Suggesting that we are prepared to withdraw the case if there are our demands that as indicated have been addressed. We wrote that letter on 8th of September last year, 2020. Up to now, we have not gotten any reply from the Office of the AG, the Minister of Agriculture, or any other body. So the person holding us from withdrawing the matter from court is not ourselves. For us, we have technically withdrawn by writing a consent.
Meanwhile, a section of farmers' union representatives have faulted the government for continuously bailing out the public-owned millers when it is clearly untenable economically.
Government continuously pump millions of money into Moroni, billions in Mumias, which is the no smoke, billions in Sony, billions in Zoya, but the end result is the farmer here continues to cry. Why? The recoveries are not able to meet the cost.
What I know is we made some requests for bare minimum to buy boiler tubes. We need some good money to do maintenance. But because of lead time, things like tubes we have, they are not here in Kenya locally. So we made a request if we can be advanced some money.
In the meantime, Sugarcane farmers in the Nyando sugar belt have been urged to halt harvesting of cane until Kibo's sugar company gets on its feet, since Muhoroni can rarely crush more than 1,000 tons in a day. Kevin Ogutu, KTN News.
Right, so let's head back to Laikipia County, where armed bandits terrorizing residents of Laikipia County launched a daring daylight attack at Mirigwit village barely an hour after the government conducted a major security operation. Journalists who were interacting with locals at Mirigwit village, 2 kilometers away from the train,